Well, we're back to talking about Godzilla, the King of the Monsters. Well, let's just get right into it. After the release of Godzilla Final Wars, Godzilla kind of went dormant, with not many films or shows that happened until eventually the Godzilla Monsterverse. But that won't be the main focus of this video. To start, let's talk about some films that were unmade from Godzilla that weren't, like, you know, that didn't see the light of day, such as Godzilla vs. Gamera, which is one that I personally would have loved to see, since I also like Gamera, and it would have been a collaboration with the Kadokawa Corporation, who do the Gamera films. But if you're interested in seeing that, since that didn't ever get made, I suggest checking out the Death Battle for it. Another film of worth that didn't get made was Godzilla vs. Ghost Godzilla. Think about it! Ghost Godzilla! Huh? So now let's move on to the first film involving Godzilla that will bring back Godzilla. Did make an appearance in one film during this time called Always Sunset on 3rd Street 2. It's not a Godzilla film, but I like how he looks here. And one thing that is actually pretty cool to note, the director of that film, he would go on to later direct Godzilla Minus One. So, moving on. Now let's move on to the first film involving Godzilla that will bring back the King of the Monsters for a modern audience. Well, modern in that, you know, besides, like, you know, like, the 90s. Was Legendary Pictures, which is the studio Legendary Pictures, decided to bring him back with director Gareth Edwards with this teaser. And with this teaser, we were given our first tease of him. Back when this film was in production, I was just like, say, always just like, say, okay, this, and this, and all that, it sounds awesome. The film starred Aaron Taylor-Johnson, Bryan Cranston, Elizabeth Olsen. The film was about humanity caught in the crosshairs when Godzilla goes against creatures known as mutos. I got it, like, when, like, yeah, like, previously say, like, when this film was in production, I was huge, like, say, yes, and all that, like, you know, like, this thing is gonna be big. Looking back, what I like the fight sequences, the battle sequences of this film. Agree with some of viewers and say that it would have been great if Bryan Cranston hadn't been killed off, because mostly he, like, as, like, you know, characters, he was probably the best part of that film at the beginning of it. And also say, yeah, the film is not a very bright film when it comes to, you know, like how the way the film is shot.
My wife died here. Something killed my wife. And I have a right to know. I deserve answers.
And all that. So yeah, like, I do like how the end of the film, like when Godzilla is facing the Mutos and he's kicking their asses. So yeah. And the next film we would get gotten was Shin Godzilla, which came out in 2016. This is the first film from Toho since Godzilla Final Wars, with the story being about politicians struggling with bureaucratic red tape in order to deal with the sudden appearance of a giant monster that evolves whenever it's attacked. This has got to be the most drastic change when it comes to the look of Godzilla, and the fact that compared to 98, yes, you can still say, hey, it looks like Godzilla, but his face is kind of weird. He's got his tail strange, and you know, he has a new atomic powers, like his atomic breath can be done with his tail and all that. It's pretty cool. One thing that is, though, is the film is kind of special to me, in that it was the first Toho film I saw in theaters, and also I saw my dad when I was in college. Rest in peace, R.I.P. This one is kind of special to me, that's just how I feel. Let's talk about the Godzilla Planet of the Monsters, which was a film that was distributed through Netflix. That was the first of a series of animated Godzilla films about a group of human refugees who attempt to recolonize Earth 20,000 years after the planet was taken over by Godzilla. And Godzilla is pretty huge in this film. In the past, most Godzilla films, the human characters are fighting Godzilla, but at the same time, they're still trying to, live with him. But this time, they're going to take him out. You know, they're looking back and they look at what has happened to our planet kind of deal. The animation for it is actually really good for the film, along with the emotional tension. If you like anime like Gundam or Gunbuster, this might be in your wheelhouse. Or heck, maybe even Pacific Rim. The next film in this series was Godzilla, City on the Edge of Battle. In this film, the humans are fighting to reclaim the Earth from Godzilla, this time with the help of a weapon known as Mechagodzilla. Godzilla, City on the Edge was released theatrically in Japan on May 18th, 2018, and was released worldwide on Netflix on July 18th, 2018.
ヘルロ。怒る。先輩は悲しみ。私の希望だったんですよ。俺たちがなすべきは人として、こちらに打ち勝つことなんです。ナノメタルを信用していいんだろうか。これは
The film introduced a new version of Mechagodzilla, and I'll say that it's interesting, you know, look. Another mech from this film was known as the Vultures. Like, you know, like, say, the ones that can fly, they have, you know, like, really weird, awesome kind of looks. Which is, honestly, pretty cool. Yeah. Then we had Godzilla, the Planet Eater. The film follows the struggles of humanity, their extraterrestrial allies, and Godzilla as they battle to survive against King Ghidorah. Godzilla, the Planet Eater was released theatrically in Japan on November 9th, 2018, and it was released worldwide on Netflix on January 9th, 2019. Well, the animation for this film is still pretty good. Well, we also have a new look for King Ghidorah, and I'd say he looks really great. It has a traditional dragon look instead of just like a big body and four heads. I mean, he still has multiple heads, but, you know, not just like, say, a big bulky boy.
That thing won't just kill Godzilla. Ghidorah. The entire Earth is going to be destroyed as well.
You plan to destroy us and Godzilla? No, the entire planet? Everything all at once?
And that is why you waited and you wished to finally be free.
With four heads and all that. So a bit after this, we'd have Godzilla King of the Monsters, where he returned to the big screen with new versions of Mothra, Rodan, and King Ghidorah, with the film directed by Michael Daughtry, helming the film. That name sounds familiar, he directed films such as Trick or Treat and Krampus. With the film releasing on May 13th, 2019 in Beijing, and May 31st, 2019 in the United States. With the film being about ego terrors awakening Ghidorah and other titans like Mothra and Rodan, and Godzilla having to take down Ghidorah. Compared to the first film, the film is a lot brighter. However, they still have some fight scenes at night. The fight scenes are gorgeous, like when Ghidorah and Godzilla fight for the first time in the rain, like when they find going, they're like running at each other, and it's just like, say, like, and then when, I also got to say one of the more dramatic moments, though, as well as when Dr. Shirazawa sacrifices himself, is like one of the more dramatic moments. I also kind of really like as like a visual moment when Godzilla goes into a meltdown state when Mothra kind of sacrificed some of her powers to help take down Ghidorah, and like he's just red as like that's his like pissed off. I think we've ever seen him in a way. Because he's melting things around him, and oh gosh, it's so awesome to see. After this film, we got Godzilla versus Kong, which was released on March 14th and March 21st, 2021, and was directed by Adam Wingard, in which King Kong clashes with Godzilla after humans move the ape from Skull Island to Hollow Earth. homeworld of the monsters known as Titans, to achieve a power source for a secret weapon intended to stop Godzilla's mysterious attacks. The film is the brightest in cinematography, which they finally figure out we want to see these characters in the light. But what are my thoughts on the film? I enjoy it. It's sort of a callback to the over-the-top Godzilla's from the 2000s, as is just how I see it. The fight scenes are great. We get some really intense moments in Hollow Earth when, like, say, all the humans and Kong are facing the hell creatures that are just attacking the group. And when Godzilla is, like, you know, trying to get to where the Hollow Earth is as well. And I do love the moment when Godzilla sees, oh, heck no, when he sees, like, the villain's daughter trying to get away, and he goes, no, you do not get away now. I do like this version, but one thing I'm also new is, I do like this version of Mechagodzilla, and that he looks like, what if crazy old Elon Musk wanted to make a robot Godzilla? Well, yeah. But the final kill of the film when King Kong defeats Mecha is great for that epic kill! It's just like, say yes! Kind of moment. Then we'd have Godzilla Singular Point. It's an anime series with monsters that had appeared in the Showa era of Godzilla. The show is currently on Netflix with 13 episodes. We should probably like say, hey, this is pretty much bingeable. With apparently a season 2 that could happen, so that's awesome.
アンギラスは未来を予測してるんじゃなくて直接未来を見てるとしたら破局?この宇宙全体がなかったことになるっていうか
Then we would get to our most recent film. Godzilla Minus One is the most recent Godzilla film from Toho. After Shin Godzilla, which was, after that film, it was kind of left alone, and Toho finally said, let's continue going on with what America's in. The film was released to theaters on October 18th, 2023. The film took place post-World War. In which Godzilla emerges, and my goodness, this film is incredible. The film has influences such as Jaws, the original Godzilla, or Gojira, and Shin Godzilla. What makes the film work so well is that you truly care what happens to the human characters and their story. Godzilla is once again a force of nature destroying with no remorse. And especially when you see him do his atomic breath and you just feel all the impacts of that. The film also got nominated this year in this year's Oscars for Best Visual Effects. It also had 12 nominations at the 47th Japan Academy Film Prize, which, from my understanding, is basically Japan's Oscars. And also, it recently got another release with Godzilla Minus One Minus Color. So it was done with black and white. And by black and white, I mean every sequence in the film was, the color was taken out. I haven't seen that version of the film, but I can imagine it still having all the impact, even without all the color. And when it comes to the future of Godzilla, it seems rather bright in that we do have Godzilla X, Godzilla X Kong, the new Empire, to look forward to this year.
Welcome to my world.
So, now that we've looked at the film history, eventually we'll look at the world of Godzilla in video games the next time. So, I will say this.
Long live the king.
Well, I mean, I'll let the character say that. I'll see you next time.